If I told you that you were perfectly healthy, and then you end up dying next week, how would that make you feel? You'd be pretty upset, huh?
I'll be dead, so...
Aha! So therefore, by your own logic, if I told you that you were dying, but yet you were healthy this entire time, you'll be pretty happy, right?
What are you getting at, man?
You're fine. No cancer. My male nurse mixed up some charts, and you're in perfect health, and you look great, by the way, so you can relax. Hang ten, brah.
You motherfucker. Next time you decide to have a drug dealer as a patient, maybe ask him, how many motherfuckers has he killed before you decide to disrespect him half as much as you've been disrespecting me?
You're chunking me.
Now this is the part when you die.
Fine.
Upsetting, right? Hang ten, bro.
Am I a bad doctor?
No, it's the Black.
It's the Black.
All substances are either acid or a base. Examples of acids are milk, your lemon, or lemon juice. Acid rain, and for your bases, you got baking soda, soap, and of course, your blood. So can anybody tell me the difference between acid and base? Anyone?
An acid is something that burns through stuff. And a base is something that,
Hey, Mr. Black, where you going? Mr. Black. Dude, we don't have time to be dicking around like this. The AP test is next week.
Hey, Frank. Look, I just want to let you know that I've been secretly teaching at your school and I quit. Yeah.
Oh. Well, that definitely explains this voicemail.
This is Doris Feldman here. I'm calling because a madman has taken over my classroom and exploded chalk at me. He's black. I mean, it doesn't. I'm just saying, not as bad as he's black, I'm just saying.
Okay, yeah, well, but in his defense, like, she was the worst teacher ever.
Well, that certainly explains this voicemail.
Yo, this is an anonymous call about Miss Feldman. She's, like, the worst teacher ever. She's sexually harassing the staff and touching their butts. So, could you, like, fire her? Yeah. All right, Jeffrey Redman, anonymous.
Yeah, you really need to start following up with your messages. Anyway, look, thank you very much for taking care of my family and letting them stay in your place. I'll see you around.
I did it. I finally traced the DNA from that apple to the teacher. And guess what? Guess who it is? Plot twist. Your brother-in-law.
Yeah, I know already. It's been taken care of.
Yeah, I know it's been taken care of? Do you realize how fucking hard it is to trace DNA from an apple bite to a human being? I had to buy my own DNA kit.
Well, that certainly explains this voicemail.
What voicemail?
It's the callback from earlier.
What the hell's the matter with you? I thought you said the doctor had good news.
No, the doctor has great news. I'm free from my toxic marriage. The world is my oyster, but yet I'm still fucking miserable.
Yeah, well, you better snap out of it. The AP test is next week. Do you have any idea how important this is? If they pass when they go to college, they can skip Chem 101 and go straight to Chem 102.
Now, are you listening to yourself? Don't you want some answers? I mean, like, who am I? Why are we here? I mean, what's the point of all this? I mean, why is stuff, you know?
Hey, man, just stop.
Hey, I had an existential crisis once, too. And then I turned 16, you pussy.
Hey, buddy. Sorry to interrupt your movie. Your mom died.
What?
Yeah. Oh, it's not pretty in there.
Get out of here. You're not my real uncle.
That's fair.
Mom? Oh no.
Holy fuck, that was weird. I never knew drugs could be so dangerous. As God is my witness, I will never do crystal meth again.
Motherfuckers can't tell me shit, Candy! You make the rules, no, I make the rules. Chemistry, fuck that shit! Fuck that shit! I could be a painter. I could be a poet! I could be a dancer.
Married, huh? Figures. First eligible bachelor I find isn't even eligible. Or a bachelor.
I ain't tethered to jack shit, alright? I'm my own man! I'm a rolling stone! I can go where I please, what I can do. Who I please.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Mick Jagger. Where do you want to go, huh? What do you want to do?
Some TV.
Yes. This is free.
His ass all of a sudden at age what, 60? He's just gonna break bad?
I'm 50.
It's weird, is all, okay? It doesn't compute. Listen, if you've gone crazy or something, I mean if you've gone crazy.
Fuck.
Hey, look, I'm a cop. You're both under arrest. No, just kidding. You're up, Junior.
10, 10, 10. My powers are growing, but I have to make sure to use them for good and not evil.
Oh, sorry, buddy. It's like a cyclone ruined your house.
Crap.
It happens. You gotta admit, though, it's kinda nice, right? Spending time with the family, sober.
I'm so bored.
Just go already. Oh, congratulations. You just got a baby boy.
A new son.
But I don't want a son.
Shyla, that's not how life works. You land on a career, you get married, you have a kid, everyone pays you $500, and then maybe you have jury duty or climb Mount Everest. Then you find out if you end up in the poor farm or millionaire acres. Or you could spin to find out if you're a millionaire tycoon. The rules don't change for anybody. The way you've been playing, you should feel lucky that a peg even wants to be in your car.
But I don't want to play. I want to fill my pockets with rocks and walk into the sea.
No, Mom. It's okay. We could play Clue instead.
God damn it, Shyla. Pool's only 5 feet deep. You have to lay down.
The bloody cops are bloody keen, bloody keep it bloody clean, bloody cheats are bloody swine, bloody draws the bloody line, the bloody fun and bloody game, bloody kids in bloody blame, nowhere to be bloody found, anywhere in Chicken Town.
Why you gotta be such a bitch? No.
Yeah, Mr. White. Yes, science.
Better call Saul.
Shut up!
My territory. I am the danger. I am the one who knocks.
Yeah.
I think it's time for us to meet. Join me for breakfast tomorrow.
So you're saying you,
Right, breaking good. Yes. I admit it is a rather simplistic parody, but I enjoy the work, and I do take it seriously. So, you wanted answers. Here they are.
So you're saying I'm living in a parody of a TV show?
That's correct. Please, have a croissant.
That's worse than there being no rhyme or reason to this universe at all. What about free will?
Well, you don't have to follow the lines exactly, but the story beats are all there. Wallace, you're a T.
Fuck you! I didn't sign up for this shit.
It is what it is, Mr. Black. You should hear this guy out, though. He's pretty smart.
Jeffrey.
Mm-hmm.
You knew about all this?
Yeah, it was pretty obvious, y'all. Move it. Hey, man. Could be worse. Could be in one of those Gossip Girl parodies. All that talking and gossiping. Oh, but what if we were in, like, a Mad Men parody, you know? You gotta admit, we look pretty dope in suits.
Why does it have to be a parody at all?
Enough! I thought us meeting would be meta and brilliant, but it has grown boring and self-indulgent. So, let me cut to the chase. In Breaking Bad, Walter White leaves being a teacher to climb the ranks of the drug trade. So, here, in Breaking Good, Wallace Black must quit being a drug dealer to climb the ranks of academia. That's the funny. Therefore, when you quit teaching and return to methamphetamines, well, that becomes a bit of a problem for me.
This is fucking crazy. I mean, you're gonna take this asshole side? I thought we were friends.
Friends? Yeah, Chandler and Joey over here. Just tell me one thing you know about me. Just one thing.
You say you're a lot?
That's what I thought, bitch.
Look, don't blame me that he wrote you one-dimensionally. I mean, does it have to be this way?
Wallace, I think you fail to realize the gravity of this situation. I'm the writer, El Escritor. You are the character, El Caractor. You will play my games. You will follow my plot lines. Or I will write out your wife. I will write out your son. I will write back in your infant daughter. And I will write her right back out. Oh!
Run.
My blood on this script is a metaphor.
What the fuck? Oh, shit! Oh, my God!
Goodbye, gay world.
Shyla, Shyla, what are you doing?
I'm really getting into parkour. What the... does it look like I'm doing?
Shyla, come on, stop it, stop it! Stop it, okay? Stop! Wait, come
no.
on, no, stop!
No.
Why are you doing this?
Because I finally confirmed what I already knew! Life without meth, it isn't worth living! You know, everything's just so hard. And for what?
You're right. No, life is... very bad joke.
Yeah, you get it. You want to come with me?
Actually, I don't see why not.
What are you guys doing?
We're getting into parkour. What does it look like we're doing?
I don't want to bum you two out, but a parkour fall from this height could kill you.
Yeah, we know.
Yeah, our universe is a bullshit parody of Breaking Bad. Suicide's the only way out.
What?
Yeah.
No. You've got it all wrong, man. Let me show you something. Look, the past is always going to be behind us. The future, forever ahead. And here we are, permanently frozen in the middle.
Scott, what the fuck are you talking about? Come on, let's just jump.
No, wait.
So this moment, right here, is how every being in every universe always feels. Questions like, is there a god, or will we reincarnate, are we in a well-crafted Breaking Bad parody, are all totally irrelevant. They don't change how blueberries taste.
So if only this moment exists, then whatever feels good at this moment is real. So that means I can smoke meth.
No, that's not what he's saying. What he's saying is things do matter. If...
Look at his face. He figured it out. Why don't you tell us what it is? Oh, wait. Don't tell us. Show us by doing what you have to do.
What was I thinking? Life is great.
Kaylee York.
Here.
Angela Chen.
Here.
Lisa Gilligan. Lisa Gilligan.
She moved away.
Oh. Well, good riddance.
Hey, it's Mr. Black, and he's covered in blood, which is a base.
Hey, man.
Hey.
Thought you were out for good. I stuck my neck out for you.
The guy who's been sleeping with my wife is right. I mean, the universe isn't really our concern. I mean, yeah, sure, it's fun to talk about at 4 o'clock in the morning, but this right here, that's what's real. I mean, we decide what's important. You know what's really important for me, guys? What's really important is to make sure to get you inner city kids into college.
Yeah.
All right, so the AP exam is tomorrow, and we got a lot of grounds to cover. So, what chapters are we covering, Jeffrey? Lisa!
Oh, what's up, old man? Look, I don't have beef with you, alright? I just want to talk to your underage daughter. I already know you talk. It's not going to be a funny reveal anymore.
Move on, Don Juan.
Okay, that was a funny reveal. Lisa, you're moving away?
Yeah, to Latvia.
To Latvia? Right this second, you're just going to go to Latvia.
People do move to Latvia, Jeffrey.
Alright, then I'll get to the point. Don't go.
Are you for real? First you ignore me, then you flick me off in front of the whole classroom, and now...
Look, I know you dissed me because frankly, you're young and stupid, but I'm old and wise, and I know that you like me. And I like you too, so... So you want to go steady with me or what?
I have to go.
All right. And I'm coming with you.
Oh, Jeffrey.
You know, it's probably a good idea to get out of the country anyway. I just shot some Black Rider, dude.
Why are you doing this? Shyla, you are being selfish.
I'm not being selfish. I'm just doing something purely for myself.
Dad!
Hey, guys.
Hey, man, what's going on?
Frank, I came to ask you two things. One, may I have my teaching job back?
Of course. I've always encouraged you to get legitimate work. Why didn't you come to me from the beginning?
Wow, that would have made things so much easier. Well, in that case, the second thing is, can I move into this place and take care of my family?
Mi casa, su casa, hombre.
Hold up, whoa! Don't I have a say in this?
Yes, you do. Look, I chose that this family is what's most important to me. And I know you feel the same way, Shyla. since you're here and not under some bridge.
Fine, I forgive you. But you have to cook me meth all the time and we have to sleep in separate bedrooms.
No, I don't cook you meth. You go to rehab, and when you return, same bedroom.
I don't go to rehab, you don't have to cook me meth. We can sleep in the same bedroom, occasionally bang, but no kissing.
Deal. But one day you realize when you smoke that stuff, it kind of makes you a very unpleasant person.
I will never realize anything.
And then everything's back to normal. Who wants a butter cookie?
No. I have to tell you all something. I have powers. Powers that you might not understand at first. Oh no.
All right, buddy. It's time for your nap.
Come on.
What are you smiling about?
I won.
I thought I had powers.
You do, buddy.